Hi friends, today's topic is voice. Voice is very important for all the students, especially those who go for competitive exams, and also this is useful for the students who are in the academic side. See, in voice there are two. One is active voice, another one is passive voice. Let us see these examples first and try to understand what active voice and what is a passive voice. See, the boy brings vegetables from the market. Brings is main verb in present form. This action is done by the boy. This is subject. So in this sentence, subject is doing the work, bring. What he is bringing? Vegetables. This is called object. And the remaining part, where from, is the answer. Is bringing from the market. So basically we understand three main parts here. One is the action, and who is doing the action? The doer of the action is called subject, and the result of the action is object. So these are the three important parts in any sentence. Let us see in the second sentence. Vegetables are brought. Vegetables are brought. Here what happened? The verb bring changed as brought, and it is accompanied with one helping verb, are. So to say, verb by adding one anomalous verb before it has become verbial verb phrase. So it became weak. And one more point, in the place of a subject, vegetables is there, the word vegetables. It is not doing this work. Vegetables are not bringing anything. But bringing is the work happened to these vegetables. So this is the major change. This is the major difference in the second sentence from the first one. In the first one, subject is doing the work. Whereas in the second sentence, subject is not doing work, but something happened to the subject. That is understood in the second sentence. So we say, first sentence is in active voice because the subject is active in doing the work. So the verb is said to be in active voice. In the second sentence, the verb became passive, and this is done to the subject. So we say verb brought is in the passive voice. Coming to the second set of sentences. My brother painted the picture. Painted is the main verb. It is in past form. Who is painting? Who is doing this work? My brother. This is the subject. Okay. So subject is doing the work. And what is the result of this work? Painting what? Painting a picture. This is object. So when the subject is doing the work, we say the verb is in the active voice. This is active voice. Coming to the second sentence, the picture was painted. Here, was painted is the verb. It shows this happened to the picture. But picture is not doing that work. Painting is done to the picture. That work is done to this picture by somebody. That is secondary. So here the verb said to be in passive voice. So we understand one point. In active voice sentence, subject based sentence will be there. Subject will be active in doing the work. Whereas in passive voice, subject is receiving the action, the result of the action. So, agent is dull. Doer of the action is secondary in passive voice. But what happened to the subject is important in the passive voice. That is the major change in active voice to passive voice. So, by the above examples, we understand these three main points. One is, voice shows or tells the relationship between the subject and the verb. The second one is that in the active voice, the subject is the doer of the action, doer of the work. That means subject does the work actively. In the passive voice, the subject is the receiver of the action, because subject does not do any work. It receives the result of the action. So these are the major points we understand by the above examples. Let us observe the points by these examples once again for better understanding. See, in the first sentence, killed is the verb in past form. This work is done by Rama. So, subject is doing the work actively. Killing what? Killing whom? Killing Ravana is the object. In the second sentence, Ravana was killed by Rama. Ravana was killed by Rama. I wrote by Rama in brackets because it is not very important in passive voice. And killed verb, it became passive and became phrase, word group. And Ravana is not killing. Ravana is not doing the work here. And what happened to Ravana is explained by the verb. So, this subject is receiving the result of the work. So, this is said to be in passive voice. Whereas, the subject is actively doing the work, it is said to be in active voice. That is the thing. The second example also same. This they subject doing this work. They won the game. But what happened in the second sentence? The game was won. means what happened to the game, which is in the place of a subject, is explained by the verb. So this is in passive voice, this is in active voice. In this way, in voice, we observe the relation between subject and verb. When subject is actively doing the work, then we say the verb is in the active voice. When the subject is the receiver of the action, receiver of the result of the action, then we say the verb is in the passive voice. These are the things we noticed by the examples. Now we will see the changes that occur in the passive voice when a sentence is changed from active voice. See, there are three major changes we see while a sentence is changed into passive voice from active voice without changing its meaning. This is very, very important, because most of the people, they do not understand this properly. So they follow only one method of changing every sentence in a stereotype manner, but it is not so. Changing of this voice depends strictly on three points, three rules. Let us see what they are. Once again, when we see these examples, we said this is active voice sentence, this is a passive voice sentence. The major change is this: in the active voice, object, the word object is coming first in the passive voice. That is the first change. So by this we understand a sentence without object cannot be changed into passive voice. This is a notable point. A sentence without object cannot be changed into passive voice. If we want to change a sentence into passive voice, we should need object in that sentence. That is the thing. So in the active voice, the word object is becoming the first word in the passive voice. That is the first rule. Then locate the main verb, principal verb. As per the principal verb and its form, you have to add suitable be form and its past participle form in the passive voice. For example, you see, killed is there. Killed is in past form. So we added be form of the be form in the past tense along with the past participle of killed. So it became was killed. Then the third point is that the subject word is coming at the end of the sentence by the preposition by before it. These are the three major rules. And whatever may be the another part in the sentence, we don't bother. These three are important. The first one, object in the active voice will be the subject in the passive voice. The main verb, based on the form, based on its form, suppose it is in present form, you take be form in its present form. Suppose the main verb is in past form, take be form in past form along with that past participle verb. Suppose it is in perfect form, go for the perfect form of be form and past participle verb of main verb. Like this, the main verb changes. And the last one, subject in the active voice becomes agent in the passive voice after the main verb added by before it. These are the three changes. For our convenience, be forms are given here. See, actually we have learnt these be forms while discussing anomalous verbs. Anomalous verbs are also called auxiliary verbs with another name, helping verbs. There are 24 helping verbs. Among them, be forms are 5. So these be forms is, am, are, was, were. When we see be as a main verb, be is the present form verb. Even this present form has got is, am, are. Past form for be is was, were. And next, past participle. Past participle is been. And then comes a present participle in the conjugation. Present participle for be is being. Then another form is there. It is to be, infinitive. This infinitive is rarely used. It is to be. Actually, these are the conjugation of be, verb be. And as per the main verb and its form, we have to take these be forms in passive voice. Let us understand by a few more examples before that we take some pronouns, how they will change in passive voice. Because see, in the changes, three changes we have seen, the last one, the subject word is becoming agent with by at the end of the sentence in passive voice. When nouns come in the place of a subject, they will not change. They remain as it is even in the passive voice. But when pronouns come, they change a little bit. Let us see those changes now. Pronouns will change like this. In the active voice, when I comes, it changes me in passive voice. This is vice versa. Vice versa means in passive voice, when me comes, it changes as I. Even when in active voice there comes me, again it changes as I, like this. I to me, me to I. Then when we is there, it changes as us. When you pronoun comes, it doesn't change, remain same. And he, when he comes, it changes as him. She comes, it changes as her. When it comes, it will not change, remain same. And the pronoun they changes as them in passive voice. When you change from passive to active, this takes vice versa change. So these are the changes in pronouns. Now we take two examples for each of the tense and understand how they change. Now we interchange sentences from active voice to passive voice taking examples for each tense. See, the first one, I make a mistake. Make is a present form. Principal verb is in present form. So, this is simple present, active voice. Why this is active voice? Because this verb make, this action is done by the subject I. Subject is doing this work. So, we say this is an active voice. Now, we are changing this active voice sentence into passive voice. Simple present tense sentence. The first rule, object is made subject in the passive voice sentence. Mistake is the object. So, it is written first. Then, verb is changed accordingly by taking a B form, suitable B form. This is a present form, so we take the B form in present form. So, what are the B forms in present tense? Is, am, are. Three are there. But you see, suitable B form means suitable to the number of the subject. Now, a mistake is the subject in passive voice. It is singular in number. So, the suitable B form is. And main verb past participle form. Make, made, made. Make is the present form. Made is the past form. Again, made is the past participle form. So, past participle form of the main verb. Before that, suitable B form as per the tense. So, is made. And the subject, this is a pronoun. So, the pronoun is changing into passive voice. I becomes me. We have just seen in the table. So, I changes as a me before it preposition by. So, this is the passive voice. For simple present tense, passive voice will be like this. And let us go for the same sentence in continuous tense. This is a present continuous tense. Because main verb is in ing form. Before it, am is the helping verb. So, this is a present continuous. See the change. This is object. Object coming first. And subject going last. Same, there is no change. Those changes are common. Because the same subject is same object. Even in this sentence also. But the change is here. At the main verb. Tense is continuous tense. Present continuous. So, we take a B form in continuous form. What is a continuous B form? Being. So, being is added. Is being made. Why is? Because am is there in the active form. Why is? Because the subject changed in passive voice. This is singular in number. I goes with only am. But singular number subject always takes only is. So, is being made. This is the major change. So, being is a suitable B form added for a sentence in continuous tense. Then you see, it is a past continuous or present continuous determined by the helping verb before it. Then, third sentence, have made is the perfect form. So, this is called present perfect tense. Present perfect tense. Same sentence, I have made a mistake. Same subject, same object. But tense changed, have made. When a perfect tense comes, we have to take the B form into its perfect form. What is the perfect form of B? It is a been. So, been made. But here changed. When in active voice, it is have. But here in passive voice, it became has. Why this change? Because subject changed. I goes only with have. Whereas singular subjects, they take only has in present perfect tense. So mistake is the subject here. We go for has. And a suitable be form is a been for perfect tense. And this main verb, past participle form. So a mistake has been made by me is the passive voice for present perfect tense in this way. Now we will see examples for all the past tenses that are simple past, past continuous and past perfect. See, the first one is I made a mistake. Made is a past form verb. So this is in simple past active voice. Active voice because this work is done by the subject actively. See, object subject same. So object comes first, then made is in past form. So we take the be form in past form. What are the forms of be in past? Was and were. Were is for plural subjects. Was is for singular subject. Here the subject is a singular mistake. So we take was made in its past participle. Because the same is repeated in past participle. Make, made, made. So was made is the suitable be form with a past participle verb. And again subject by plus me. This is passive voice. Then past continuous tense. Difference between present continuous, past continuous is only helping verb. In present continuous, is, am, are along with the ing form verb will be there. In past continuous, was or were along with the ing form verb. So here it is, I is a singular. So was is the helping verb along with the ing form verb. Was making. Was making is changed as was being made in the passive voice. This is the major change. So this is a passive voice. And I had made a mistake. This is the past perfect tense. I had made a mistake. Had plus past participle verb form. This changes like this. A mistake had past participle. Perfect form for be is been. So been is added. The verb is already in past participle form. So it is as it is made by me. So this is passive voice for past perfect tense. So using the correct be form is important in passive voice. It is based on the main verb form or else tense of the active voice sentence. So this is the main point. Let us see future tense. Now we will see the examples for future tense. How the sentences in future tense change into passive voice. First, future itself is known by will or shall. So in all future tenses we find will or shall. Especially shall is with I and we. So the subject is I here, we have used only shall. But when subject changes other than I and we, the helping verb also changes. That change you can find here when you go into passive voice. See, shall be, shall make is a future form. So this shall make is changing as will be made in passive voice. This is because mistake is the subject changed in passive voice. This object here came as a subject. So the subject is in singular number. Other than I and we, in future tense we take will. So will is taken. And in be form, directly be is taken in a future tense. Will and shall, they always take be. So will be made. The past participle of make is made. So this is passive voice for simple future tense. And future continuous tense, generally this is not used many times, but for the sake of example we have this here. I shall be making a mistake. I shall be making a mistake. So this is changed as will be being made. Because this is continuous tense, we take being in continuous form, and will be is common, because will is just because of this singular subject mistake. So will be being made. This is the passive form for the future continuous tense. Future perfect tense, shall have made, it changes as will have been made, because in perfect tenses been is taken as the be form. So been made, will have is a future, future perfect. So in this way, this is passive voice for future perfect tense. So please note very important point. While changing an active voice sentence into passive voice, the major thing, the main important rule is that change the main verb into past participle form along with a suitable be form. Suppose it is in present form, take suitable be form in present. It is in past form, take be form in past tense. It is in perfect tense, take be form in perfect form. So like that, this is the major important change we have to observe while changing a sentence into passive voice from active voice. Now we move on to the worksheet. వర్క్షీట్ లో ఇచ్చినటువంటి సెంటెన్సెస్ యొక్క వాయిస్ ఏంటితో మనం రికగ్నైజ్ చేయాలి. ద ఫస్ట్ సెంటెన్స్, సునీత చేంజ్డ్ ద బెడ్ షీట్. చేంజ్డ్ ఈజ్ ద మెయిన్ వర్బ్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ పాస్ట్ ఫామ్. సో వర్క్ ఈజ్ డన్ బై ది డూయర్ సునీత, సబ్జెక్ట్. సో సబ్జెక్ట్ ఈజ్ యాక్టివ్లీ డూయింగ్ ది వర్క్. So it is said to be in active voice. Second sentence, Mr. Ravi had told him everything. Had told is a past perfect tense, and the work is actively performed by Mr. Ravi, so it is said to be in active voice. The workers were being satisfied. When being comes, we can blindly identify that it is in passive voice. Being comes only in continuous tenses, and it is past continuous because were is there. So it is in passive voice. Fourth one, Swami will have read the book. Will have read. When have comes, it is perfect tense. Will is there, so future perfect. Because in future perfect, when been is present, then we say it is in passive voice. But been is not present, so it is active voice sentence. The bill has not been paid. See this. In this sentence, has after has been is there. Been is followed by past participle verb. So, it is in passive voice. Friends, this is our topic today. Voice. How to change an active voice sentence into passive voice. And what is an active voice? What is a passive voice? And what are the major changes that occur while changing a sentence from active voice to passive voice? These are explained only for getting you a view, a clarity on the voice, on the topic voice. I hope you got some clarity or idea over this topic, and we'll meet again with a new topic in the new lesson. Thank you for watching.